Welcome back to Reading Bear. Today, we will take a look at some new I Don't Work Here Lady stories. And if you enjoyed my content, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and post some bear emojis in the comments. Let's go!
The first one is titled, A More Wholesome Story. So in high school and 12 more years I worked at the local grocery store. It was right across the street from a big video rental company that only has one location left. Anyway, I stopped by to rent a movie after work still in my uniform, which was not a blue shirt. One of the ladies, I know as a regular at the store, says, "Hey Joseph_kickbutt, can you help me find this movie?" Thinking it's because we have somewhat of a friendship, I walk around, find it and hand it to her. She says, "Thanks for finding it so quickly." Then, I go to find something to rent and she says, "OMG. You helped me and you don't even work here. I know you from the grocery store, but my brain just knew you would be able to help." She was super embarrassed and I told her not to worry about it because it really wasn't a big deal. She then paid for my candy for her mistake. The next one is titled, I work at a petrol station, so I apparently work at all of them, happened just this morning. I'm tired, so I'll keep it short. I had to collect a jacket from a seamstress. I had to pop into a petrol on the way. Now, I've worked in petrol stations for years and still do. The last one had full American-style service and I was the attendant for several years. Left that place years ago and went to another. As I was leaving, a little Toyota pulls in, a woman of about 60 jumps out. OTL, old Toyota lady, me, the night shift zombie OTL, can you fill my car? Immediately spotted she was talking to me. My mistake. Old habits. I'm tired having not long finished a night shift. I am a retail vampire, come join us, the undead. Mahaha. OTL, come fill up my car. She repeated, clearly annoyed. Me, I don't work at this garage. I shouted back over the traffic noise. Old, you work at that one out of town, me, and, please note, I'm tired, hungry and have to complete my vital mission, you'd understand if you know the jacket's owner, that means you work at the rest of them then, I've read a load of IDWHL stories and I don't want to go through the crap of Karens, so, no, I don't, and got in my car and drove off. There are traffic lights right outside the station's exit and it's red. I heard her say, well I never, and saw her take a picture of my car as I waited at the red. It turned green before anything happened. It's just the way she spoke, that tone that retail workers everywhere hear before getting a migraine. I was too tired to give a damn. Besides, I didn't work there. The next one is titled, Are You Colorblind? I was recently in a hardware store. The employees wear dark blue polo shirts with the company name embroidered on it. I was wearing a bright orange t-shirt with my company name in large letters across the back. I was looking at the Safely glasses when I heard a middle-aged lady say, "Excuse me, do you work here?" Wow. I'm not even wearing anything close to what the employees are wearing, but she did ask very nicely. "Sorry, but I don't work here." Immediately she apologized for bothering me. She was so sincere and nice about it, and I, having 30 years of retail experience, could not suppress all those years of service. I found myself saying, "What are you looking for? Maybe I can help you find it." She said she didn't want to be a bother, but just could not find an item she saw in the store's weekly ad. I knew where the item might be, and a moment later I had helped her find it. It was in a large box that looked a bit heavy. She said she had bad shoulders and asked if I could help lift it off of the shelf for her. I said I would do one better and took it up to the register for her. She was so grateful and kept thanking me for my help. She had another item she wanted to find, and so I got the attention of an actual employee and sent them off on a new search. I saw her again as I was leaving, and she thanked me again. I smiled and just said that I was glad to be of some help. We agreed that these little acts of kindness add up to make the world a much better place. And we all need that. The next one is titled, I'm just gonna ignore you if you try to talk to me, this just happened. So I'm shopping around the ever-busy mall ward, yes I call it that. I am wearing a jacket, a wool cap with a huge pom-pom on it and am wearing my purse and I have a cart full of stuff. I'm looking at pizza and I hear someone say, "Excuse me?" I ignore it because why the hell wouldn't I? I grab my pizza and start to push my cart away. I hear, "Excuse me," again and of course do my own thing. I'm walking and I hear the woman behind me repeating, "Excuse me." "Excuse me, but I keep walking." I glance behind me and I'm only other person in this aisle than this woman, and she's glaring at me. As I go to exit the aisle, I hear the woman shout, "The people that work here are so goddamn rude. Like, lady, how do I look like I fucking work here?" The next one is titled, "I only went for an umbrella." Alright, so it's raining a lot recently, and I do not have an umbrella, and I've been meaning to get one for about 2 years now, because it often rains whenever I'm working and it'd be nice to have a day where I can stay somewhat drier than I end up being usually. So I live with three friends and we rent a three-bedroom place together. Now my two friends have both got umbrellas. I do not. So today I decided, I've finished work early, it's still dry out, I can quick walk to the supermarket and buy a umbrella for myself for when it rains. A 20-minute long walk to the store normally takes about 5 minutes, but I forgot my mask like an idiot and had to double back for one item, the umbrella. Only, it started raining heavily. I'm drenched from head to toe, but I was determined to buy an umbrella. Now the umbrellas are located pretty much near the main entrance, can't be 30 steps away from the doors. I'm dripping wet, so headed into the bathroom to use the built-in hand dryers to dry my shirt off for like 5 minutes and just generally get a bit warmer. Eventually I walk out, no longer dripping, walk over to the umbrellas which are about 10 steps away, pick up one lone umbrella out of like 100, pop it open just to see how big it is. There's different sizes in the boxes from small, mediums and large, tag for size was on the inside, then close it and almost like magic. Poof. A Karen is stood in front of me and asks me, or rather tells me, "Hey you. Give me that, I want to try it out." To which I reply, "Sorry lady, I'm only here for this, there's plenty more literally next to you," to which she yelled, "I wanted that one you have, it's pink and I want it." Okay, first of all it was a plain black one, anybody with eyes could see that much. "Lady, you can see this is all black, right?" She yells at me again, "Liar, go get me your manager, I want you fired for not letting me purchase that umbrella." There's a customer service desk literally behind me where there was a manager who straight away walked over and asked, "What's the problem here? He won't give me that pink umbrella he's holding. I stashed it away so I can come back for it and he's stealing it from me." The manager scratches his beard, then his head, and says, "Ma'am, that's black, in fact they're all black, we only stock plain black umbrellas here unless it's a kid's one which are rainbow colored." I sighed, popped it back open, spun it around and just said, "Look at the umbrella lady, it's black," she stuttered, confused, and said, "Well, where's the pink one you just had before that?" Manager, "Listen ma'am, there's no pink ones, just plain black ones right next to you." He was visibly getting annoyed. "Now I'm sorry if you've somehow misplaced or lost a pink umbrella in some other store, but it definitely wasn't this one." I go to turn away and go pay for the umbrella when she grabs me, spins me around and says, "Hey, I'm sorry to bother you, but can you go check the back for me? I know there's a pink umbrella in here somewhere, it was right here about 10 minutes ago before you walked up." "What? I don't work here, lady, what made you think I worked here, and what makes you think I would go to the back to check for you even if I did after you just yelled at me?" Karen, "Well, the customer's always right. So chop chop, come on, go look for me." This is where me, the manager and Karen go around and around in circles for like 30 minutes telling her I can't go back there, I don't work here, he can't fire me, I'm a customer as well. In the end the manager just tells me go look in the back, then whispers to me, "Just walk past her and head to the checkout, say James the manager gave me a code to enter for 50% off, the umbrellas were only £2.50 anyway so I just accepted it." I got to the checkout, gave the code, got my 50% discount that I didn't need, a new story for Reddit, oh and a scratch card which I won £20 on, and walked on home in the rain, completely forgetting I just bought an umbrella and didn't open it on the way. Major facepalm. The next one is titled, "Accosted by children at work." So I work as a vendor for big box stores, it's an easy job. I make my own schedule, I work my own hours, and most of it is auditing and taking pictures of shelves. Easy, pays the bills, and I don't hate it. However, the amount of "I don't work here" stories I have is ridiculous, because I'm wearing dark clothing and a lanyard so I obviously work everywhere. I've got a ton of them, but this one in particular is one I know a lot of you will get a kick out of. This was before Wowood. It was a beautiful crisp day and I was wearing a black t-shirt, grey leather jacket, jeans, had my purse on me, sunglasses on my head, and the only thing indicating that I was even working was a purple Super Nintendo lanyard around my neck. I definitely don't look like an employee. But regardless, a man with two little boys who looked between 4 to 5 was glaring daggers at me. not saying anything, just glaring. As if somehow I was going to spontaneously gain the ability to read minds. It was super creepy, but I'm not about to approach a random Kevin in the store. I go into an aisle to continue my work when his kids quite literally run up to me and grab me. One has his hands tightly wrapped around my leg and the other one has a hold of my purse. They're tugging at me and screaming, "Daddy wants to talk to you. Don't ignore Daddy," as I'm trying to pull them off of me. I feel like a zebra about to be killed by a pride of lions as the dad starts to storm down the aisle towards me. Definitely a trap. Just as I think I'm done for and my day is ruined, an employee intervened and explained that I don't work there, but she can help. I take this glorious opportunity as help from the gods and pry myself free and book it towards the entrance to take an impromptu lunch break. As I get up there though, I am again captured. I turn around and the same kids have their hands on me. At this point I'm pretty pissed off and firmly tell them to go back to their dad, all the while they're still babbling and screaming at the top of their lungs the same garbage. Again, I pull myself from their grasp but they keep trying to cling to me. It gets to the point where a manager actually comes over and asks me what's going on. As I'm relaying the entire story and trying to talk over the screeching kids, I hear another very, very angry man screaming at the top of his lungs. The classic, "How dare you, who do you think you are," etc. The dad's back. Awesome. Is he mad at his two small children for running off after a complete stranger? No, of course not. He's mad at the random young lady they're accosting. Apparently he's convinced that I'm kidnapping his children, and calls the police. So now that my day really is ruined, I have to sit in customer service as the police go over the footage. The dad won't stop screaming, his kids won't stop screaming, management is defending me, and I want to sink into the floor. And of course it's serving as the best birth control of all time and giving me a massive headache as I'm certain my ears are now bleeding. After everything is said and done, I'm cut free and the dad gets charged with wasting police resources and is banned from the store because apparently he's done this before. Parenting at its finest, ladies and gentlemen. Because while the dad's behavior was absolutely abysmal, the fact that he condones his children running up to perfect strangers and actually grabbing them, holding onto them, and screaming at them is beyond me. To this day I can't decide whether or not they were trained to do that, or it was a complete lack of parenting. The next one is titled, "Maskless Lady." This happened just yesterday, and my wife thinks it's appropriate for here. I was shopping at that inexpensive family clothing store named after a military branch, you know the one. The store is mostly empty because it's the middle of the afternoon and because of, you know what, most people aren't out and about for shopping no reason. Anyway, I was looking for some jeans at the front of the store because they were on sale. Mind you, I was actually wearing a pair of jeans, a plaid shirt, a vest, and a mask that all could have been from the store. As I'm searching for my size, this lady approaches with her phone to her ear and her mask in her hand. I pause what I'm doing and look over at her. "Lady, do you know where the men's athletic shorts are?" Me, no. "Lady, can you ask someone?" Me, no. "Lady, don't you work here?" Me, no. "Lady, oh my gosh. I'm sorry. Why didn't you say so?" Me, "Because I was trying to figure out why you wouldn't put down your phone and put on your mask when talking with a stranger in public." The lady's face went from confused to horribly embarrassed. She immediately turned bright red, put on her mask, mumbled, "Sorry," and headed straight out the door sans shorts. I find jeans in the right size and head to the checkout behind me. The cashier has these big smiling eyes and I can tell she is smiling behind her mask. She tells me, the look on that lady's face was priceless. Have a great day. The next one is titled, "Okay, I do work here and was just joking, long time lurker and finally opened an account after reading some stories. Near where I work there is a salvage yard and I would visit it at lunchtime before the lockdown about once a week. It is fully of unusual things from around Ireland ranging in age. So it may be just some business clear out with modern bit but a lot of antiques too. As I have always been interested in old things, I have a fair knowledge of some unusual looking items and I may just even recognize part of something. The yard has a lot of Georgian and Victorian components because it is in Dublin and there are a lot of such building about. Anyway, I stroll down at lunchtime to have a look and never take off my lanyard for work as I always have it on in work. While browsing around the store, I go to the location they put new stock and there is a table with various different brass bits and pieces. While looking at the table, a woman comes over and starts looking at them. She picks up a few bit and looks puzzled, so AI causally tell her that the item in her hand is part of a Victorian meat grinder, and she seems even more confused, so I hold it and shower her how it would fit and then see a complete one and point to that so she understands. She is obviously American but is grateful and then proceeds to point at different things on the table, parts on the table, and I know what they all are: part of a door handle, lock mechanism, tinder hooks, etc. Lady, you really are good at your job. Me, oh, I don't work here. Lady, you Irish are so funny. Me, no, I really don't work here. Lady, laughs, points to my lanyard, winks, so funny. Me, okay, glad I could help. Lady then walks away sniggering, so I continue walking around, and as I go there so often and the place is a mess, I do occasionally push things out of the way to walk by or put them things together that have been separated, as I can't help myself knowing they could get lost. AA group. Lady arrives over at me with her husband holding a Guinness sign. It is a reproduction sign that I knew. Husband, this say 40 euros, can I get it for 30 euros? Me, I can't do that as I don't work here. He starts haggling. Me, okay, you can have it for 30 euros, but remember I don't work here and I already told you. They both laugh. Me, just tell them at the counter Stu said it was okay for 30 euros. We all laugh and I wish them an enjoyable time in Ireland, as they are sure to bring back stories of how funny the Irish are, and I left. A few days later, I went back to the yard and asked the guy at the counter, did an American couple ask for a discount on a Guinness sign? He started laughing, was that you? So as expected, they went to pay and mentioned me as a helpful guy who said they could get it cheap. The staff proceeded to say nobody called Stu works there and as it was new stock they don't discount it. The couple proceeded to tell them that I had mentioned I didn't work there 4 times but I was just joking. They all thought it was funny, so let him have it cheap, and the couple laughed and said so he does work here. They laughed and said sure he does. When I have gone in since, they asked me what price they should sell something for. We are pretty sure the Americans think we were all in on it, as some Irish sense of humor. The next one is titled, Do I Look Like I'm Wearing a Costco Vest? This was years ago as a teenager. My high school job was as a shelf stocker at a Canadian pharmacy chain called Shoppers Drug Mart. It also has cosmetics, diapers, some groceries, and other such things. One day, after a shift, my mum came to pick me up, as I wasn't yet old enough to drive myself. She was headed to Costco, so I had to come with her. She has MS, and at the time simply walking a long distance was like running marathon for her, so I was happy to come and pull stuff off the shelves for her. Anyway. There was a good sale on flats of bottled water, so she had asked me to pull a couple flats off of the large pallet that had been left in the aisle. I pulled a couple down, and put them on her cart, when suddenly some random Karen decides I should get her some water as well. You see, I was still wearing my uniform shirt from my actual job, name tag and all. The exchange went something like this: Karen, oh, I'll take 3 of those. Me, what? K, the water, get me 3. M, I don't work here. K, well, you're wearing a uniform. You have a name tag. M, a uniform and name tag that both say, Shoppers Drug Mart. This is a Costco. K, I'll complain to a manager. M, again, I don't work here. I roll, walk over to my mother, who has already started to leave. K, well, you don't have to be so rude. And that was that. I'm a pretty big dude, and don't usually smile unless I'm actually happy about something, so people usually just leave me alone. I guess all it takes to become the servant of some Karen is a shirt and a name tag, even if that shirt and name tag looks absolutely nothing like those of the actual store employees. The next one is titled, Karen Goes on a Racist Rant Then Tries to Complain About Me to Store Staff. I work in a very busy downtown area of a city. The building I work in is a mall on the bottom and offices on top. I'm a supervisor at a large company and often dress very professionally for work and need a security pass to enter, exit my building, which I keep attached to a thin blue lanyard which hangs out my pocket. During my lunch breaks I usually go to the food court of the mall, then walk around the retail stores to stretch my legs. This happened around January before everything was shut down for Woolworths. I had a quick lunch and was browsing one of the much larger department stores. I don't like leaving a mess, so whenever I take something up I try to fold it and put it back. I was looking at a sweater and didn't want it, so folded it and started putting it back when an older woman came up looking irritated and asked where she could find a specific section of the store in the national language of my area. My area speaks a different language than the rest of the country, so it's a regional language but not the national language. Officially we're bilingual. I normal just respond, I don't work here. but I figured I'd be helpful since there weren't any sales associates in the area and pointed in the direction and responded in English, "I'm not sure, I think it's over there," and start to walking away. This lady became a full-on Karen and started cursing me out, first in the national language, saying that immigrants coming to this country don't respect their language and culture and don't have the decency to respond to people in their correct language. How we should all just go back to wherever the hell we came from, I'm citizen from birth, biracial, but with a long lineage from the area. She then started in English that we were in AX speaking country and I was obligated to speak to her in the language of her choice. I responded, "No, we're in a bilingual country and I can speak whatever language I choose." I then turned around and walked to another section. Shortly after, I'm minding my own business and I hear the familiar voice nearby. The same lady followed me to another section and was flagging down an associate. She right away asked to speak to the manager. I wasn't entirely convinced this woman was that stupid to not realize I didn't work here. Employees had name tags with the store name. But when the manager got there, she literally started saying how she wasn't impressed with the store and that their service was terrible and that she would report the store and that, pointing at me, employee, to the language police. Yes, it's a thing here. Me, the manager and the sales associate all share a WTF look and I just start laughing. The manager politely says I don't work there. The lady gets even angrier. Starts insisting that I shouldn't be allowed in the store and should be removed from the mall entirely for being rude and impersonating employees. I laughed and told her I work in the building, lady, they can't remove me. She then insisted on learning where I worked, she could complain directly to my employer. I nopped out of there and decided I was just going to stick with the "I don't work here" from now on. The next one is titled, A Tale of a Midwestern Auntie and the Missing Naruto Cards. We all need to have some wholesomeness in our social media diets of despair, dread and dreariness. It began with a shopping trip to a town in a nearby state that contains a super bullseye. At the end of my time there, I went towards the self-checkout, but as usual the aisle in which they keep Pokemon cards caught my eye. "I'll just take a peek," I thought to myself as I stepped into the space, eyes scanning each pack carefully as if I actually intended to buy one, or five. I may or may not have a problem. That's not the part that makes this story. The important part came when the middle-aged woman next to me piped up. "Do you know anything about Naruto cards?" she inquired. I looked over the goods hung on the display and shook my head. "I don't see anything related to Naruto. I see Yu-Gi-Oh and Dragon Ball, but not Naruto." The woman explained to me that she saw that Bullseye's website showed the cards there, but she couldn't find them in store. She also told me that she had checked the game shop in the same town, with no luck there, either. "I don't know anything about this anime stuff," she sighed as she told me about her nephew in Texas who collects Naruto cards. Although it couldn't be seen under my plague-appropriate face mask, I smiled to her and explained how I personally didn't get into Naruto, I prefer more obscure anime franchises, namely vintage 80s or 90s ones. Currently on my watch list are such examples as Maple Town, Dirty Pear and Creamy Mammy, but have knowledge of a shop that has a decent amount of anime merchandise. It's one of those tabletop gaming sort of joints that have goods related to other nerd-adjacent hobbies like gaming, anime and to a degree, trading cards. We parted with a thank you and I went to continue my shopping trip and get my Starbucks fix, but even now that I'm at home, I'm wondering about the lady and the Naruto cards. I hope she found some. Her story reminded me of how I was at her nephew's age, anime obsessed. Except instead of Naruto, my main obsession was Inuyasha. "Did you know Sengo is responsible for my gay awakening? You didn't ask?" Well, now you have to think about a stranger telling you about their first cartoon crush. You're welcome. Be good to each other. The world doesn't need more negativity when we're in the middle of a flipping plague.